Hi guys, this is my first tutorial for Unity. I have been developing games and applications in Unity for more than 2 years now, and this is the first time that I have decided to create a small tutorial. This is my new game, Rewind Time, which is gonna be available on the Play Store in the next few days. So in this game there were very very few things that I didn't knew. One was the in-app purchases that I have never implemented in any of my games. Usually my games are built for PC, so I never had to go through the in-app purchases, but this time when I'm focusing on Android or maybe a mobile phone, the in-app purchases is where you get money from the user or the player and they get something in return. So if I want to buy like 10 coins, and if the player wants to buy 10 coins and he can pay me 10 rupees or $10 or whatever your local currency is, and he will be rewarded 10 coins for those $10. So that's what the in-app purchases is for. This is a very good way to boost your revenue. So let's start. So Unity has a very codeless in-app purchases system that I discovered recently. So the structure is very simple. So I'm gonna explain what the structure is. Under the Windows tab, there's a Unity IAP button available. If this is not available for you, you will have to go into the services panel, you will have to enable the in-app purchases, and you will have to import the Unity IAP. You will also have to enter your Google verification transaction ID so that everything is intact, everything is set. Okay, now I'll explain each and everything. The create IAP button is for creating any IAP button, Unity IAP button, which will have a IAP script and a product ID, a IAP catalog, a purchase type, on purchase complete, on purchase failed, and all the rest of the things. I'll explain everything in a bit. Okay, so this is the IAP button. Now the second button in the Unity IAP is the IAP catalog. This catalog is where everything happens. Okay, so I have a few products that I have created for my game. I'll explain what each product is and what is there inside the advanced panel and all that. So the very first important thing is gonna be the ID. So product ID, each product should have a unique ID. I have used my package name and the product name as the product ID. Then the second thing is the type. So the remove ads is gonna be a non-consumable, because the user or the player is gonna buy it only once, and that's it. The in-game currency or any sort of power-ups is gonna be a consumable type, because the player can frequently, or I can say that the player can buy more than once. That's what the perfect explanation is gonna be. So yeah, okay, now let's go into the advanced section. So this is the first tab, is the description. So you can select whichever language you want, and you can add a title and add a description to it. Okay, now there's a translation panel as well, where you can enter, suppose if you want to go with Italian, you can enter the Italian title for it and then the description for it. Okay, but if you don't know, just leave it there. The payout is gonna be something that the payout way of the button is gonna be. So whenever the player buys something or purchases something, the value is gonna be change accordingly here. But I would recommend not to do anything here. Like, this is useful if you know what you are going through. Okay, whatever you exactly want, if you know what you exactly want, you can do this, or else you can skip this part. Store ID overrides. Okay, so this is where each and every store is gonna have a ID. Okay, so the ID you have placed here, each and every store will also have a ID similar to this. Now you can override the store ID for each and every stores. So if you want to create a Google Play store ID, you can, you know, copy this and add a Google Play at the end just to have a clarification. Now this is a developer's choice. I won't, like, I personally won't override anything because the game is not gonna be very big, or it's not gonna be on multiple platforms. It's just gonna be on Android and iOS. So yeah, store ID overrides. You can have multiple store IDs, different store IDs. Okay, now comes the most important part, is the Google configuration. Now this is the place where you add the price tag. Now no ads is gonna cost you $199. Make remember, this price is gonna be in USD. So enter the value you want in the USD, and whenever a person calls this particular price, the Unity will convert the whole price into the your local currency. So don't worry about it. It will convert everything into the local currency. So make sure you enter the price in the USD value. Now pricing template is something that is going to be created on the Google Play console. So if you have something there, you can directly paste the values, paste the ID, pricing tag ID, and that's it. Now Apple configuration is something you will have to place if you want to upload your game for iOS. There's a price tier, and you will have to select the values accordingly. Like, if you want to place the value, like the ads, just no, buy all ads is gonna cost you $7.99, so you can set the value there. And for iOS, you also have to upload a screenshot. So like, I am not gonna do that right now, but this is something very important. Okay, so this is the whole IAP catalog. Each and every product you create is gonna have the similar structure. So if I create a product right now, there's gonna be the similar structure, and you will have to implement the values there. If by chance you don't like what you created, you don't like the product you created, you can just click the cross button here, and this is gonna delete the product. Now integrating the product with the IAP catalog. Now you have created the product here, but the implementation is not done. The IAP button does not know that what you have created. So we will integrate the button and the IAP catalog in a second. There's something more important right now. There's a very important feature that Unity provides, is the Unity purchasing initialization. Now this is a recommended feature. Now what will happen is, if you enable this feature, Unity purchasing will be initialized whenever the scene starts in the awake function. Okay, you can like, it is your personal choice as a developer, but you can also initialize the Unity purchasing after a while, or something, after a few things you want to do and then you want to enable, you can do that. But this is gonna be recommended because Unity purchasing is gonna be initialized at the very beginning. Okay, so now let's close the IAP catalog and let's integrate the IAP catalog with the IAP button. So now I have this button over here. Now what will happen is I have created the whole catalog here. Now I have to integrate the button. So I'll go into the drop down under the product ID, and I have to select whatever product ID, like whatever product I want to set for this button. Okay, so I can set it by 200 coins, and that's it. That's everything. Now there are two callbacks. There are two functions that are gonna be called. One is gonna be on the purchase complete, and one is gonna be on the purchase failed. So if there's something particular you want to create or want to make sure happens after the purchase is complete, you can add here. Or if there's something particular you want to set for the player when the purchase is failed, you can add here. That's pretty straightforward. Now comes the title text, description text, and the price text. Now the title text is gonna be, so whatever you have entered in the IAP catalog as the title is gonna be viewed or shown in the title text. Similarly goes for the description and the price text. Now the price text is gonna be your local currency price. So many developers have this question, like I have entered the value, like the value for the particular IAP in USD, and I live in a country where USD is not supported, or USD is not the local currency. How will the transaction take place? What is going to be the taxes for it? And so you guys don't have to worry about it. The local currency value is going to be set here, and that's it. So I'll show what the shop or the IAP in the shop is gonna look like. This is my shop and more money, and I have created a few in-app purchases here. Now you can see that each and every value, like each and every price, is $2, $2, $2, and the description and the title is same. Now whenever I'm gonna show you what has exactly happened. So if I go into the shop, and you can check the money I have right now, it's 11,550. Now when I go into the more money, you can see that the price, the description, and the title has changed accordingly. Now if I buy 1000 coins, this value is supposed to go to 12,550. Okay, now whenever you press this button, IAP button, there's gonna be a fake panel shown in the Unity editor. Note that this panel is only gonna be shown on the Unity editor, not on your phones. So don't worry about it, this is a fake store. So if I press buy here, coins have increased, and that's it. So basically you have integrated your IAP in your games. So this is the codeless Unity IAP system. So if you have any doubts, or if there's anything you want to know, comment below and I'll look into it. Also you can check my games that I have uploaded on the Google Play Store. So yeah, thank you and bye-bye.